I've unfortunately seen people forget that the fraction bar needs to be treated like a grouping symbol. So let's take a look at a problem. If I had 5x plus 4 all over 3 equals 12. Now, what I've unfortunately seen is people try to do something like this. 5 over 3x plus 4 equals 12. Well, I'm sorry to tell you, that's wrong. Don't do it. Okay? What I'm going to say instead is you could do the following. This would be a little bit hard, but if you were careful, it would work. 5 over 3x plus 4 over 3 equals 12. You could do that, and it would work, but let's take an easier path. Ready? Here's the easiest path. We're going to say, treat this as if it said 5x plus 4. All of that grouped together and then divided by 3. Let's change this into a division. Equals 12. Oh, well now it should become more obvious that if I knew what x was, I'd multiply it by 5, then I'd add 4, then I would divide by 3 to equal the other number. Fine. Once again, we're going to use inverse operations, and we're going to undo things in the opposite order. What does that mean? Well, if you knew what x was, you'd do this, then you do that, then you do that. So undo this one, undo the divide by 3 first. Well, the inverse operation of dividing by 3 is, of course, multiplying by 3. Here we go. If I was multiplying by 3, I would say, look, dividing by 3 and multiply by 3, they cancel each other out. That was the point. This right here would be, well, let's find out. It would be 36 equals, and this would be 5x plus 4. Well, that's not so bad so far. Let's keep going. This is just a normal two-step equation. We've solved many of them. Minus 4, minus 4, 32, 5x equals. And then I'm going to divide by 5, divide by 5. I get x equals 32 over 5. Someone else might write x equals 6 and 2 fifths. And that is my final answer.